present are George Ryan, Pat DeAngelis, Sarah Schwartz, Kathy Shane, and Lynn Griesmer. Absent is Shalini Bowman, and there is no audience or staff here. So I have no announcements. I have general public comment. There are no people here. If they show up later, we'll allow them to comment. So we're going to go right on to the presentation and discussion. So needless to say, I've been thinking a lot about, well, what do we take to the council for action, and what do we take to the council, what I consider a working document, okay? So that whole thing of just the goals from last time, to me, that's what we take to the council for action.
Okay.
And it is on the agenda for the 22nd, okay? And so I'll make a presentation about it, talk about our process, and so forth. So we need to agree today to forward that to the council with our recommendation for action. The thing that I think we also give the council, and this really gets into the a little bit of the process as well, and that is that whole other sheet. And I've made some changes to how I've worded that other sheet. I've moved all of the goals over that as we agreed on them last week, the wording, okay? I've also reordered them in the order we did last week, okay? But then on the second column, I've added something that says referred to, and it's in capitals. And basically that is where we say, okay, which committee is really gonna deal with this? And let that committee look at the suggestions for activities we've had, but let them come up with their own.
Right.
So just like bylaws did already,
right.
But you know, CRC is just getting started, let them come up with their actions. The same thing with OCA, the same thing with rules of procedure is almost done. But you know, so in other words, pass it out to our committees so that we're not here trying to second guess what committees are thinking.
Does that make sense?
Okay. So it would be two documents. One will be, here's the rules, okay? I mean, excuse me, here's the goals.
Right.
And then the second document would be the worksheet. What else would we want to call this?
Worksheet's good. I mean, right now it's called Council Goals, Activities, and Timeline. And then from committee date, with changes accepted, right? So that's the document.
Yeah.
And
those are in our folder right now.
Right, it's from committees from 4/8/18, and then it includes a lot of track changes. I want to clean this up before we send it on. But I did put in the word worksheet. And I'm just trying to come up with what we want it to finally look like. Because, and then, just let me say, as much as I thought we might be finished, I'm not sure we are, because I think they have to come back to us by a date certain with their suggested activities and timeline, understanding that they can change.
Yeah. So you want each committee to look at what has been done so far, and then design their own activities and timeline?
I want each committee to look at those goals that are appropriate to that committee.
Yes.
So in the actual thing, you'll see, for example, the very first one is the Amherstown town government, establish a new form of government. I don't have it's me in many ways, maybe that is us.
We're a committee of the whole for that one.
Right. The second one is
town manager evaluation.
Of course, we've said let's subsume that above. And so that's, again, committee of the whole. Then forming the economic.
Next is public engagement.
Establish economic and community development committee.
And that also gets assumed into that. But my assumption is going to be that the recommendation for that will come from CRC. Okay?
Yeah, that would make sense.
Lynn, I don't know whether you want to, as we go through these, that's the one, you know, the flow is really nice of the first two, and then establish a new committee feels like something very different on some level. I mean, you want to figure out whether we need it, what it should look like, you know.
Right.
So it's not,
right,
we're absolutely
right
going to do
absolutely
it, but we think
right
we might want to do
right
it, which
right
is different than all these other goals, is
right
we really want
right
to do it. So I don't even know what I'm, where I go with that, but like
okay
that, does that become an activity under something else?
Right.
Right. It just feels different than we have to do an evaluation, we have to do the following.
Right.
When
right
we discussed it last time, that was just earlier this week,
yep,
we said it should be subsumed under the town goals, town council goals. I'm sorry, under the town council, whatever we call it, creating a new
form
government
of government.
Amherst town government.
Mm, okay.
Yeah, and that's what, and I could you could even then make an activity, consider establishing, you know, like we're
right
trying to figure out whether we need some, you know, what it would do, because we'd be establishing a new town-wide committee.
Or reestablishing.
Or reestablishing,
yeah,
you know,
there was one.
And two people said it didn't work, but I don't even know what
yeah
that
I,
yeah,
I've
what
learned
is
to kind
you
of
know,
just
it's like
disregard that.
You know,
I've
but it's
told things yeah before, and it's like, yeah,
yeah.
Okay,
and then
going,
well,
let's
the
see
it,
no, you're right, right,
what was the it? Yeah, so I would just, it's move it, yeah.
No.
Okay. Let's not dwell on that for a moment.
Okay.
I just want to make sure you understand what my goal is by the time we're done today.
Good.
It, my goal is to have the one sheet that we say,
yep,
here's the goals.
Right.
We, the committee, recommend to the council that you adopt these goals. Okay. The second is to give to the council, not for adoption, but this worksheet, and basically for each of the goals, be able to say, this goal is being referred to this committee
mm-hmm
for them to look at what we thought about, but come back with their solid plan.
Yep.
So
okay
do you want to say refer to or send to each committee?
Referred. Referred to respective committees.
Okay.
So let's not try to refer the first one. The,
right,
the next
right
one is the goal of public engagement and communication. Develop and adopt processes that encourage broad resident participation. OCA.
That
right
should be a natural, yes.
That's a natural.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
We're still establishing that, but we'll look at it and work on it. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
No, but you're, this all you're going to do then
yep
is come back to us
right
with a plan
right
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 of how you're going to do that.
Right.
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 Not what you're going to do.
Could I just, you know, in the terms of the way this would look,
mm-hmm,
so over on the left is the goal, however it's been listed.
Mm-hmm.
That first whole set of where we're appointed, all of that disappears.
Yes.
And we have something that says referred
mm-hmm
to OCA, and then you see OCA on each of the tasks, right? That's what you're imagining this would look like?
Right.
I think that looks great. Mm-hmm. You know, because otherwise it's duplicative in a way. First row of column two duplicates your column four, but that doesn't bother me. You know, I mean, like under it referred to
mm-hmm
and then the suggested activities
mm-hmm
flow underneath it, then
mm-hmm
it's OCA is doing all the work.
Mm-hmm.
So in a way,
well,
you are,
that's
yeah,
right?
I can see why you like that. Yeah.
You know, I mean, so it's clear who
yeah
is
right, no
doing
yeah
the thinking.
Yep, yep.
So I think that structure works.
Okay.
And I'm just,
but now let me throw a little wrinkle on it. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Because what we don't have here is an appointments goal.
Mm-hmm.
And I raised the issue, should we have a separate goal for appointments? But in many ways, that also comes under establishing a town government.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's where all the standing committees are.
Right. So
just let me continue
yeah
going through.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Then the next one. Budget and fiscal. Establish an annual calendar, blah, blah, blah. That's finance committee.
Right.
Okay. And we'll come back to all these little comments
right
and stuff
sure
like that.
Mm-hmm.
Then we said, well, maybe we need a separate one for JCPC. I wrote a little note and said, I think this needs to be under budget and finance.
I think so, too. I think, you know, if we change that process, it comes out of our standing committee and
mm-hmm
then flows to the committee that's running it.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
You know, I mean, they're doing it. But
mm-hmm.
Right. Okay. So then the next one is the elementary school district.
Mm-hmm.
And right now, it's a TBD, so I think it's just a council of the whole.
I think it's council.
Committee of the whole.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Should I say committee of the whole or town council?
Just say town.
You can say town council, you know what I, you know, since I get in, I'm so imbued in these rules, reading other towns, they often call this a committee of the whole. I think just because they're saying this is a, they're tasking themselves to do this, as opposed to this is their general role as the legislature. So I don't care, but that, I was thinking, what is a committee of the whole if it's all of us?
So under that, maybe I should remove finance committee?
Yeah, and, you know, it, to me, a responsible party is the only thing finance is gonna do is at the point there's money involved.
Right.
Something gets referred to it.
That's right.
They're not an actor in it.
Right.
This is up above anyway.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're just moving on. So then, I didn't even write one because we didn't have one for the regional school district. And adopt assessment plan and budget was what we said.
Right.
So again, it does seem to me that when we write it, it's a town council committee of the whole.
Yeah.
And the only difference with that, which is gonna be fine, cause you can do it over in your little responsible
finance committee.
Is finance is involved in that negotiating out the assessment. The assessment method, setting the guidelines, then the budget comes back. But that's the only, that's the real difference, is there's an actor there that's helping the council, cause it's the money part.
So you know what, in many ways, I think for that particular one, as long as it stays on assessment and budget, it's finance committee.
Yeah.
And then comes the council, obviously. They all come back to the council. None of them stay in their committees. Okay, then higher ed, I guess it's town council committee of the whole.
You know, I was just gonna make one suggestion, Lynn, I mean, and this is more on activities. To make that leap you just did, going back up in budget and fiscal.
Yep.
You could put a line in regional school budget and assessment, you know, that somewhere in, you know, you have convened public forum on the budget, you could just stick it in one of those. Cause we're gonna, you know, on this set of activities along here, budget and fiscal, your regional school budget.
See, but I think what we were trying to do is have a separate goal.
But it'd be fine with me.
So let me just, I can make a note up there. In finance, address regional schools.
I don't, let's just see what we did with
regional school budget.
Which,
and
what I really like is just the goals.
And CPAC.
Yeah. Cause you're just the goals, I'm just flipping back and forth.
Right.
These are the high level things,
right.
So they
That's
have to
right.
appear at the high level somewhere on the worksheet, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Good.
So then higher ed, it's a town council committee of the whole.
But referred to, question mark.
So I think at this point, it's committee of the whole until we come up with something other.
You know,
I wonder, that's what the same thing I was gonna say is CRC, resources.
When we wrote the charge, it's one line in the charge, right?
Yeah, it's concerned about them being just overwhelmed with work, but.
CRC, yeah.
I think there's gonna be some changes or subcommittees probably need.
Yeah.
And when you form those, you could call on other counselors to help, I mean, that's.
You can call, you can basically form working groups.
Yeah, good, that's great.
And when you form working groups, there could be like one or two counselors from the committee, another one or two counselors that are not on the committee, and.
And people.
Human beings.
And the rest of the world.
Human race.
ROW.
So, yeah, so I think that we should.
You think that's CRC?
Yeah, I do.
Yes, absolutely.
Wait, you see how many CRC gets in there?
I know.
One of the many reasons.
We're good at setting up subcommittees and working groups.
We are. Okay, so then capital plan projects, adopt a comprehensive. I think it's finance committee and this is where I falter because I'm not sure that at some point, you know, let's just leave it with finance committee. If they decide they need to come up with a subcommittee on this or something, they can do it.
No, right.
No, it's true.
I mean, that's where we start with a model anyway.
I'm not sure where else it would go unless we start imagining
let's not.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay, finance committee on that one. Rules of procedure is obvious, that's rules of procedure. Bylaw review is obvious, bylaw review ad hoc, and then CRC because of zoning and planning. Okay?
Yeah, yeah.
Then we had one about public ways.
And you've still kept this, this is what's interesting, because when I flip back and forth, the question is whether public ways stays at a very high level.
Right.
Subsumed under larger transportation plan, or what is it?
What do you think? It go under larger transportation plan? I mean, there's other, for instance, there's other responsibilities of the council that we are, they're actually gonna come up in the next couple of weeks. One is setting sewer and water rates. Another is the whole issue of people renting rooms in their houses.
Airbnb
tax. Because we have the option of adding 3% on top of the state tax, which would match, by the way, what our hotel tax is. Those are gonna come up, and public ways. And these are all stated responsibilities of the legislative body. So, do we take this and we put it in transportation, except for the fact that we're gonna get a recommendation, or do we take it and put it up with establishing a town government?
Which
this is public
ways.
Public
ways. Adopt a plan for improving public way requests.
To me, as I understood why it went to GOL, so when it was, we're regularly gonna get these requests. Can't we have some logical ways of pre-approving them and saying to the town manager, you know, they don't always have to come to us the same way we've given him.
And that's what we're working on.
And so that's what you're working on. So it's a way of, so to me, it's one of these, we're trying to get it off our own agenda. The way we made a board of licensure, and so it's going to be, because it's different than a lot of other things.
And we'll be reporting to the council about this.
And so who should it go to?
Well, right, to GOL.
Stay with GOL on that.
It'll be GOL that the council will vote it out, and then at least what I'm understanding is most of it moves off the council's.
Well, some of it definitely moves.
Some stays
with the town manager, and some stays with us. And the council will finally decide. Well, we'll make our recommendations, and you'll look at
it. Am I right that you're thinking, like, if they only want one parking space for an hour, the manager, you know, something like that's an easy one to do? If it's easy, just do it.
So where else would this go?
Well, see, I'm thinking it goes in the same place that we haven't mentioned. Water, setting rates, okay, setting rates, setting taxes, et cetera. And it seems to me that that's.
I put it under the last finance charge, but I wrote it, may review water and sewer rates under fine, you know, I mean, just in, where do you refer a rate structure to when it's big, as opposed to small changes?
That's a good question. Let's not get hung up on it. Let's just say for the moment it's gone to GOL, and after the recommendation comes from GOL, then we can work on it. So now we're to the 1 year and beyond, year one and beyond, and that's master plan, and that is CRC and planning board. And I think I need to say and planning board, because they really are the ones that oversee it. So it's gonna be a matter of whether CRC can come up with a good working relationship to do that together.
Which would be really nice.
And then zoning is, well, it's CRC eventually, but for the moment, it's also in bylaw review.
But it's also, there's a, you know, it's, my comment was dropped in somewhere. There is, I've mentioned it before, so I don't want to just repeat, there's a zoning subcommittee, zoning, that is planning to bring a bunch of recommended something.
And is it part of the zoning board of appeals?
It's underneath planning, so it's a planning zoning subcommittee.
That's right.
It goes back to the planning board, and then Chris Bestrup has to write the report that comes to the council.
Right,
you know, but
right.
they've been working.
Yeah, they've got a couple of things.
Is that
right.
Their name? Planning, zoning subcommittee.
Yeah, when you go onto it, it's find it when you go to the planning board, and then underneath it, it has this. It meets an hour before the planning board sometimes, and then half the time it's canceled. But the only thing they're doing is drafting possible changes. So
okay, so it's CRC.
But this, Lynn, just so you know, you don't have to put the subcommittee that much. It will come to us from
the
planning. From
the planning,
planning
board,
right.
The including the planning board
the entity
and subcommittee.
That will be sending
and
it. They, yeah, will be
and CRC, planning board, does ZBA get it? Just let it, leave it at that. It goes to CRC, and they have to work with the planning board.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Then the next one is housing, and we have nothing. But it's, it gets referred to CRC.
Yeah.
Review, develop, and adopt comprehensive housing plan by ordinance.
Is that in any way in the master plan? It seems to me that there are references.
Well,
it is, but we decided housing is so important.
Yeah.
We wanted a separate goal.
Okay.
It's very definitely part of the housing plan, and it's very definitely working.
And then when we look across where you've been going to housing, Trump,
right?
And you know, it's across several committees,
right?
Yeah.
And one of the things I was going to say, like just like CRC is talking about collaborating with the planning board, this may be a place where we're collaborating with the housing trust, and because they have been doing so much work.
You know, I noticed. You know, this is I'm going to just do a brief segue, but. I saw that the planning board assigns liaisons, and they've got someone assigned to housing trust, someone assigned to conservation, and I'm betting that CRC is going to have to say someone's following what's happening with housing. So, you know, it's the early alert that something is coming.
Yeah.
Right.
You know,
right.
So that the counselors say, I'm going to be either on this or following it
right.
in some way, because it will be an early alert, something is about to flow to us. So, you know, 5 months from now, maybe.
Right.
But
right.
Remind me that you and I need to talk about liaisons just
okay.
after the fact. Okay.
But I thought that was an efficient way for them. What they're doing is trying to know what might be flowing
oh
to
yeah,
them.
No,
yeah.
I
like
true.
That idea.
So, transportation, we said CRC and GOL. And you know, GOL, right now, right here, we have public ways.
Right.
But public ways is very, you know, the big committee in town is TAC for that, and they're about to become more active, and it's kind of in everything.
Mm-hmm.
It's buses, it's roads, it's sidewalks.
Yeah,
it was
there. It was awed by him.
It was an
stuff.
Odd,
yeah.
It was, the agenda was stunning,
but
right?
I'm going to take GOL out of here.
Yeah,
because
I think it is,
no,
because it's CRC and TAC.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay. And parking, CRC, and town council?
Yeah.
Now, again, this is in the weeds, and so maybe we're going to leave it for now. But we went to the parking forum yesterday.
Yes.
And a comment was made to me that I thought was quite appropriate, that once the downtown parking group closes up shop, which would be, I guess, in the early summer, we should consider, creating some kind of subcommittee or implementation group that would then make sure that these things actually get done, or the ones that need to get done.
Mm-hmm.
So is that something we want to put in a document like this, or is that something that just somehow we have to remember, you know, in the summer that, you know, it just gets
created? Should you put in, like, continue work at the downtown parking group, or, you know?
This would be a new body.
Create a new entity.
You'd have to create a working, whatever the downtown parking, it's called a group. Create another one that would have some.
I think that makes sense because
it's an implementation.
Right.
Would we consider it a goal?
I think the goal would be to make sure that gets created.
I don't think it's a goal. I think it's an activity.
Okay.
But it's for the council. It really doesn't. Unless you want to. Who's going to take that on?
Yeah. So what, George?
CRC.
Yeah.
I'm afraid their list is going to get so long, things are going to get lost.
One of the things that will happen with CRC after a year, or have, might say,
even before that,
would you some towns have more than one committee doing these things, mm-hmm. so it might be like the five of, we're subdividing constantly, mm-hmm. but it would be a judgment after what's dominating most of the time.
Right, that makes sense, yeah.
But this is something that I'd like to see, I think we'd like to create it by the summer or late summer.
Yeah, and
okay, so it's considered creating an ongoing parking committee.
Well, right. it's an implementation working group that will take the report that, and its recommendations and see that they get implemented.
So okay, it would go under these activities, and just as the select board created this thing you're talking about that's about to end, there's in the rules that you will see when they finally come, we have the in within our ad hocery world, you know, mm-hmm. other, you know, it's a thing that's got a limited duration. You're appointing it for a year, you're appointing it for 2 years. Mm-hmm. We could do another one of those. I mean, that's in S what the parking group was.
Right.
They picked,
right.
and it wasn't of the council necessarily. I mean, it has BID on it, it has a whole bunch of people.
Yes, I think
yeah.
it would be a mixed
group. You'd want the same thing again. It's a work.
Right. Maybe some of the same people, but definitely and it needs to be done in the late summer. When this group ends, we should. But where does it go here? Or does it go?
So
it goes
I added in a step after review and discuss downtown parking study, discuss concerns of North Amherst over parking and Mill District. I reviewed, consider creating ongoing parking committee.
So you stuck there. That makes
including
sense.
Including implementation of recommendations from.
And that makes sense. I'm looking at your timeline. That makes sense where it. Us making a decision to do that, and the we can't see her. You're not typing in SharePoint, right? No, so she's sticking it as I understood it, right? But to me, fall 2019 seems right because the other one is just closed down, and then we're setting up something.
Right, it's going to take a while for the report will come out. Mm-hmm. People read it, they'll digest it. There are some very, I think there are going to be some very specific recommendations,
right.
And then somebody's got to figure out what gets implemented.
And then what do we do?
Right. Well, those recommendations.
Right.
Implementation of
right.
what we choose.
That's right. That's right.
So the very last one is energy and sustainability, and I put ECAC and then CRC.
Well, I was going to add CRC because I think
mm-hmm.
yeah.
Okay.
So let me do this. Let's for the moment shut out of this and go back to
just the goals.
Just the goals.
Okay.
You got it. Just the goals. And this is the one I sent that has just the goals, version 3, struck out.
Yep.
So this is just the goals, version 3 with modest change.
Yep.
Well,
I have an older one. So
ongoing,
this has been
ongoing 7.
It's not very different from what you have.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So I want to make sure you are comfortable. This is the one
that
you would adopt and recommend. I think, first of all, we want to call it draft. Whoops. I just wiped everything off. Draft. Town. Group of ongoing.
That's where we have the question about the economic and community development.
All right, that is an ongoing, is it a subset? Consider setting one of these. Here it is. You know, consider, right? It's underneath you. Pat, you're right. She's got it as a sub goal under the government.
Under Amherst government.
Right.
We had this discussion, or I feel like I never was involved in it, or it became economic and community development. My understanding was originally
it was just
simply economic development, period.
Right.
Community development's already in the CRC
right.
title. I was going to suggest, if people are willing or open to it, to just make it, the original thought was to create an economic development committee.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And that was its primary function.
Right.
Community development is just too broad and vague.
Okay.
This is economic development.
Okay.
And the event that happened today, the forum that will be held next week would be the kinds of things that would seem to be that, you know, the kinds of stuff they'd be excited about.
And that's one of the things under.
It's under Amherst Town Government. It's the third item. And I always would suggest we strike and community.
Yep.
Yeah,
I'm having no problem with that.
Okay.
And should I just say establish instead of reestablish?
Yes.
And then the question is, it should you, to differentiate it from our committees and our subcommittees, do you do a town-wide economic? You know, make it clear we're setting up a
right.
new thing that's
right.
not us.
It's not a council.
It's not a council.
Right.
Stay here for a moment with just Amherst Town government. What else should be addressed here? Is this where appointments should go?
Well, I guess I'd go back and look at your activities, you know, without wordsmithing this, but I like the high... What you're trying to do with this, I think, is this high-level thing.
Right.
So it's not do every single activity.
Right.
So we're setting up our committees. We're we've got a functioning appointment process.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I would, you know, like you could do. We've got this TAM. We're doing evaluations. We've set up a new committee, and we've got a functioning appointment. And you could do them all. A functioning appointment. Outreach and communication process. I mean, it's just like we're
mm-hmm.
going to get all
mm-hmm.
of those in place, right? So in one long sentence, Lynn, rather than each of them as separate, to keep it instead of each of these things as a separate task.
Okay, here's what I'm going to suggest.
Yeah.
Rather than us try to...
Or you could just make the high-level goal.
Right. And this is where I think the goals commit, the ad hoc group continues to oversee this.
Okay,
group.
Okay.
So the TBD is going to now become town council goals ad hoc committee. And you're not going to get dissolved as fast as you'd hoped.
Is that already picked?
Huh?
That already Fridays. Because I'm going to a movie at 7:05 no matter what happens.
That's fine. I'm meeting up with my husband for dinner.
All right. Good.
There
good.
You go. Okay. Now.
So do we want to add on another line or two related to appointments, communications, and outreach?
Do we add a whole goal?
No. I think under the town. I like it under the town government.
Because part of establishing a town government is to establish a functioning and agreed upon process of making appointments. And part of forming a new town government is to establish and create policies that promote citizen engagement, and we call it communication and outreach.
Yeah.
So that's establishing your standing committees.
You
no, that's different than
mm-hmm.
the committees, I think.
Is that
I think what George just said is we're putting in place processes townwide that are appointments or outreach, communication, public participation.
Right.
Just
that is part of our creating this new form of government, isn't it? Really?
Yeah, none of them.
Mm-hmm.
The way we're doing it is not the way anyone did it ever before, right?
Mm-hmm. No, because we're just a whole different kind of government, so that all those things have completely changed. So we are setting policy
right.
as a new government.
It's our goal to see that this happens. Yeah. We want the community involved in every possible way.
Right,
and
so
that's not a standing committee thing. It's a larger goal of part of the larger goal of establishing.
So
mm-hmm.
what is the wording?
Maybe implement new appointment process, communicate new appointment, communication and outreach processes.
Policies.
What? Or policies, right. We have processes.
But see, in my
yeah.
mind,
yes.
That was, that's a standing committee, okay? And then that standing committee.
Called OCA, right.
Called OCA.
Right.
Has.
So you're trying to differentiate between a part of the government and an activity of the government, in which case
mm-hmm.
town
yeah.
manager evaluation
right.
doesn't fit. The townwide committee fits. You know, if we're not doing a function, but I mean, if we're, you know, in other
only
words.
The only reason that I say it.
I mean, we have to do that. But we also have to appoint.
You know
people.
What? We may not. I don't think we're going to be able to get this ready, this working sheet ready with all this detail.
But Lynn, what I'm wondering is on. If I didn't have three sub-bullets, I'm looking under just the
goals.
You're
on the single sheet.
If I'm on just the goals,
right.
and the just the goals said, Amherst Town Government, establish a new form of government, end of sentence, not three subheaders. And then over in our worksheet, we have all the things we want to set up.
Oh, I see.
Because
like
it's
that
the
would be then town manager evaluation.
It was over.
Economic development, blim, blim, outreach.
Because on none of the others, on none of these others'
policies.
High level goals, do we have all the sub bullets on them.
Right.
I know the when I read down the
right.
others, it's
mm-hmm.
we're doing this, we're doing this, we're doing this, rather than the four things that are part of it.
Yeah.
So it's I think it's cleaner.
If we shift those sub points to the worksheet.
Yes.
Yeah, just leave them over there, and we're saying we're setting up a new government.
And hopefully the council will be, have both of them in front of them. And, they
and I know you don't want an adjective, but you could say establish a new and great form of government. a new and delightful
an exemplary,
form.
Exemplary, outstanding.
So I'm
establish a new dictatorship.
No, wait a second. No.
Right. I'm in agreement of wiping out
the three
sub things on the one-page version.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yes.
That's all I'm saying.
As
I'm
long
not,
as
absolutely.
These are on the worksheet.
Yeah.
Yes.
As long as they're on the worksheet.
Right. And then also
how does that feel to you, Sarah?
I'm processing.
Okay.
So let's
okay.
just keep going.
So you keep processing.
Do you have the one, you know, because what I like about the others is they're clean. I mean, they're
yeah,
clean
no,
and
you,
that.
You made a very specific and good point.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the outreach, communication, and appointments stuff is in the worksheet.
Yes.
Right? Under town government goals, town council, that first head.
Yeah.
I'm not looking at both, I'm just looking at one because I'm too incompetent to look at them.
I'll get the other
so,
one.
So now we're on this one the one pager that says, here are the draft town council goals.
Right.
And eventually we're gonna say as recommended by.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So
now the next one actually is
you know, I'm going to.
Which is?
Well, the next one, public engagement and communication. We just shunted that over to.
Right, that's been under the established government.
But I really like it here.
Yeah, but I do too.
I think it needs it to be in both places on the worksheet because it's part of establishing a new form of government.
Mm-hmm.
But we're really very specifically saying that we really want to encourage broad resident participation, which we're not saying under, yeah.
Right.
And it's very important that it's a goal.
I think so too. I like it high level.
And I like it
yeah.
up at high.
Because
yeah.
it's,
right.
it's kind of, yeah.
Because
yeah.
even if OCA discusses it, it's a burden for all of us. No?
That's right.
Yes.
It is a responsibility
it's
for all of us.
Right.
Okay. All right. So I've made sure it's noted under the town government established. Okay. So now we go back to the list.
Budget and fiscal.
So Lynn, I just one comment, and then I don't want to wordsmith what I'm seeing here. Worry about the verb or tenses on some of these.
Oh,
so if something.
Always. I'm not.
Yeah.
You'll never offend me by editing.
Okay. So now all I'm saying is if something is ongoing. We're not establishing, adopting an assessment plan and budget for the region. We're adopting assessment plans and budgets. You know, I mean, it's, in other words, if it's ongoing, it's not
it's
a one-time thing. So just think on each one of them how you
okay.
approve annual budgets, provide guidance for coming.
You know, those seem to me, they're worded in a way that says ongoing, and then I hit one that says, we did it and we're done.
So let's go back with that in mind, to the very top one. Establish and continually improve?
No.
Establish. Okay, develop and adopt.
Processes, see, that one to me is an on, feels ongoing, because you're not finished, you're developing.
Establish an annual calendar and so forth, partner with the elementary.
Provide fiscal oversight, approve annual budgets, there I would strike the, and just strike approve.
Yeah, you got it, George, that's where it is, that's where my problem, it's approve annual budgets.
So, establish an annual calendar, comma, provide fiscal oversight, comma, approve, strike the annual budgets, add an S, and provide guidance for.
And then you, so, and then you could go, you could say for future fiscal years, you know, so it's, you're, oh, for future, you know, it's not just next year, but every year we're gonna be, so provide guidance for future fiscal years.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's all I'm looking for, is that can.
No, that's good, elementary.
I'm not doing this in correction, shoot. All right, let me go back up and track. Okay, elementary school district, partner with.
The elementary.
I'm two with us.
This is very specific, we're gonna make this, so do we wanna look at this in this ongoing way? What would, what is the role of the town council in relationship to elementary school district?
Maybe it's to support the improvement of elementary school education.
That is more of an open-ended goal in essence, and then.
It seems a little.
Yeah, it does, it's not quite right.
This one at least is, this one's like, you know.
But this one is very specific, boom, we build one or two schools, we're done. And I don't think that we're done ultimate, maybe we are, because there's a separate elected body. But it does seem to me like, what is the ongoing nature of our relationship with public schools, our public schools?
We gotta be careful here, because we have this school committee, and that's an elected body, so we really don't wanna make it sound like we're somehow setting policy or somehow directing what the school committee is doing.
Partner with the, what about partner with the elementary school districts to continue building educational opportunities? It's too yucky.
What was, we liked about this was it's focused on something very pressing and clearly a goal of the council in the foreseeable future.
Right.
But at some point, that is right, it will be, we hope, over and done with, one way or the other. So it's not ongoing in that sense.
I could move it to one, year one and beyond.
Yeah, I think that might be where it should go, and it would just be that particular issue. And I'm not sure we should, I don't know what the others feel, but I don't feel strongly that we have anything really insightful to say about the schools in terms of large goals. It doesn't sound kind of just.
So.
We want great schools, yeah, and so what?
Yeah.
I want you to look at elementary school, regional school, and higher ed, and I'm gonna suggest that all of them should be one year and beyond.
Yep.
Yeah.
And now, don't we, in an ongoing fashion, this is my ignorance speaking, don't we in an ongoing fashion adopt an assessment plan and budget? Is that, that's.
We do, but for instance, this last time, we adopted one, and we hope it lasts for 2 years, but it could be called into question after one.
But doesn't it keep coming back to us year after year after year after year after year after year?
It does.
So I just think adopt annual assessment plans and budgets. I mean,
yeah,
I think for regional school districts, yes.
Annual assessment plans and budget.
That's an ongoing thing.
It's gonna happen every year.
Yeah.
Yep.
But with the elementary school district, we have a school committee, and I don't think that we should be weighing in here.
So, a couple of things, we actually don't have an elementary school district unless we merge with Pelham, we just have elementary schools.
No, we have an elementary school district. We have an elementary school committee, we have an elementary school district.
Do they call it a district when they're doing the school committee?
Elementary schools, that's what it's called, but it's a district.
So they do officially, okay. And are we partnering with the district, or are we partnering with the school committee?
Well, I'm suggesting we take the whole thing out. I'm sorry, we're moving it down to.
To one year and beyond.
So we're still keeping it, and so your question is partner with.
I just don't, we're not literally gonna well, I don't care who we partner with. You know, just whatever. No, in other words, there's something we're working with, and it's the school. It's the school committee, right? It's the school committee.
The school committee to build a new elementary school for Amherst.
And I was just going to.
And that goes down below.
I have a one word possible. I'm not sure. I like it better to secure a new elementary school. So we're not going to actually build it. We're hoping we can secure one, you know, so, mm-hmm. you know, like, keep it going. So I was going to change it to secure, but I don't really care. I mean, people understand what it is, you know, doing everything we can to make this.
Right. We're not going to be overseeing the.
We're not going to.
Assuming it finally gets.
We're not going to be in the design plan for
exactly
the school.
No,
we're not
going to
be in the construction or the site selection.
But we
want
to partner with the school committee to secure a new elementary school.
Yeah, so that's. I was just thinking that that's.
So, do we keep this an ongoing or do we move it?
I think we move it down.
Down to
and do we
year
move
one
regional
year,
district
year
the same
and
higher ed the same?
No, I thought we felt regional school district every year ongoing we will be adopting assessment plans and budgets.
Right, that's so.
That should stay and it should be in the plural. Because that will
right.
be ongoing. Hopefully, it won't be a building school. We'll be partnering with the school committee
and
ongoing.
And maintaining and strengthening relations with the higher ed institutions
that's
is ongoing.
Ongoing, right. So the ongoing thing with elementary schools is we also approve the school budget. You know, we do. They
part
that's
of
what
our
we
budget.
That's what we just did a month ago, you know, when we all had the public hearing.
So you're saying we just had the same thing assessed.
It is different because
well,
there's not because
was on the regional budget.
Right, but
that's right.
Right, so Mike's the elementary school will just be part of
our regular financial
a part
budget.
Of our regular
just like the library.
Right, it's just like the library. But so it is. It's just different because we don't have to go negotiate with four towns over the assessment piece of it. That's what's really. If we ran the middle and high school by ourselves, it would be folded in. Okay, so I don't. I was just saying, there's part of the elementary school.
It just feels strange to have ongoing elementary school. It feels strange to separate three educational goals.
It does.
Yeah.
I feel like they're either ongoing or.
Well, since we think it's going to take at least 3 years to get in our. Elected.
In our tenure,
in
it's
our
ongoing.
Tenure,
okay,
if,
here we go.
If it's going for all three of the years that we've been elected for, by definition.
And it may, and it will.
Right.
And maintain and strengthen relations with our higher ed institutions.
Yeah. It's never off our plate during the time we're just elected for.
Right.
So we're not certainly not finished in year one, because year one will come before we know it.
Mm-hmm. How are you doing?
You know, I think in minutes you could be saying, "We discussed the goals and refine the word and refine the wording."
What I have is a review overall town goals document. And I have two documents. I have one goals in version 3 with modest changes now to draft town council goals, which is the one we're using. And I did two worksheets for each of goals and referred to respective committees. And I did put something and discussed what goals are being referred to what committees reflected in finished documents. So I also was thinking I have a lot of like, we are going to like appointment stays with goals ad hoc committee under town government, set up a list of goals and a worksheet. I have all these things, but I may just say discussion of activities
and
goals
and
reflected
and
in panels.
Yes.
And
incorporates
yeah.
into
right.
her
that's
document.
What,
yeah,
I agree because you're gonna have the working draft that we saw at the beginning, the draft that we got at the end,
mm-hmm.
so
right.
everyone wants to see what happened
right.
to
yeah.
it.
They can also watch this.
Okay, so then we have under year one.
We think.
So we're not moving anything. Okay.
I'm sorry, what are you saying?
We're not moving elementary, regional, and higher ed.
No, we're leaving
okay.
them.
Under year one.
Yeah, remember.
Year one, capital plan / project.
Rules and procedures, bylaws.
Develop and adopt rules and procedures, complete and adopt the general and general bylaws. develop and adopt a plan for improving public awareness. Anything else in year one that should be in here that we're missing?
Well, every year we take up sewer and water.
The sewer and water reading?
Yeah. But we won't take up public ways request. It's not, it doesn't belong in year one.
More like year one and beyond.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
No, that's totally okay.
Okay. All right. Wording on any of those? Because I'm going on to year one and beyond.
No, one works really well because it, they all have a period on them. This will happen this year. This mm-hmm. will happen this year. This
yeah, you
will
just
happen.
Have a capital A under develop and adopt rules and procedures. Should be a lowercase a. Minor.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Okay.
Sometimes I don't even know the change of this thing.
So then we go to year one and beyond master plan.
Review, revise, and adopt the master plan.
I think I take that next sentence out.
No.
Does it develop and begin
well,
implementation?
That's right. We're taking out these sub things
gotcha.
Unless right.
Okay. Under zoning, I think I take those next thing.
Review, assess, and revise zoning bylaws and conformity.
They're all over in the other sheet anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Housing. We changed it to adopt a comprehensive
housing plan slash priorities. Mm-hmm. I think that's right.
Can I,
mm-hmm.
on housing, and why do I feel different about housing
yeah.
and transportation? I don't know, but right. housing makes sense to me. On transportation,
yeah.
having just sat through TAC,
yeah, exactly, really.
We're grappling yeah. with, we don't have enough money to do what we want to do, so
mm-hmm.
we're forced to say what three things can we do this year, what three things can we do next year.
Mm-hmm.
And it seems to me the council will have a fairly limited role in that other than making sure the capital budget pays for what we, you know, so it's interactive with like do we, making sure, so I don't have a, you know, so what would be, I do think we should take up what are we doing with buses or not, so maybe I don't feel any differently. You know, like
I
when
think
I think of transportation, we're not running the bus system. Yeah.
Right.
We're not figuring out which road gets done mm-hmm. next.
Right.
I think the real question on housing, transportation, and parking is what is really the role of the council?
Right.
Is there going to come a time when we will have a comprehensive housing plan in front of us, just like we do a master plan?
Mm-hmm.
Is there a time when we will have a transportation plan with sets of priorities in
mm-hmm.
front of us?
Mm-hmm.
And is there a time where we will have, say, this is where we wanted to punt, established plan to develop comprehensive
we punted on
strategy.
This one.
Mm-hmm.
Figure out something about parking. So I guess, so I shouldn't even raise this. I think the answer is yes, because on transportation, I can imagine different kinds of things we would have to consider.
Mm-hmm.
And also priorities. I mean, wouldn't they want to talk about, you know, okay, so tax doesn't want to do this, we want to do that. The council might say, no, there's something more important.
So, and the example would
right.
be
I
the select board adopted complete streets as a,
mm-hmm.
as a vision, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that in theory comes with some teeth to it. And
mm-hmm.
then we, in another arm of government, don't observe it where complete streets are supposed to have sidewalks and bikeways and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But that was a policy, you know, so we should grapple with it. Does that
mm-hmm.
If we're going to have a policy on the books, are we going to enforce it? And what does that
right.
mean, right? Yeah, so I take it back. I feel the same way.
Okay, so let me do it. I'm going to go at this another way.
No, so I'm good with this.
Under
being
housing,
high level.
Transportation, and parking.
Yeah.
Shouldn't they all basically say the same thing?
Yeah.
That we're going to review, develop, and adopt.
Yeah.
Yep.
A comprehensive housing plan slash priority.
Yeah.
Comprehensive.
Review, develop, and adopt.
I'm even happy if
and
I have
and
to
adopt comprehensive parking.
I have
okay.
to say I would
okay.
be happy with dropping comprehensive, but I like review, develop, and adopt. But I'm fine if you want to keep in comprehensive.
Because why do you want to drop comprehensive? What's your thought there? I mean, we're thinking about the whole picture, not just affordable housing.
Right, we're talking
retirement
about.
Well, housing,
and I say
right.
Maybe I feel different about housing because on transportation,
because
we're the town of Amherst and not the state of Massachusetts, I think we need a train going over to.
Right,
to Boston, you know, we've got things that don't work because there's not a bigger transport. We are not in control of transportation in the same way.
Right.
Yeah.
But
right.
We could be. So
yeah.
I should take.
So that's why I feel like we can.
So leave it in.
Leave it in.
Because
we could shape
something. Yeah.
Yes.
So
at least be a voice.
So that's fine. Leave the adjective in.
But
so all of them are going to say.
Wait a minute, Georgia.
So all they're going to say, review, develop, and adopt a comprehensive plan priorities.
Mm-hmm. For the first two, yes.
How about the next one?
Parking, he wants to
talk.
Well,
I thought Evan had a great little comment. He said, I don't know what this means. I don't know what it means either. You know, parking seems, it's like politics. All politics is local. It seems to me all parking is local. It's a local thing depending on where you are. I mean, what's a comprehensive parking strategy?
On this one would just do develop a parking strategy.
But even that, I mean, what's that mean? I mean, you have issues in North Amherst, so you address them. You have issues downtown, you address them. But there are lots of places where there are no parking issues, and I'm not sure how they're connected. How's the North Amherst parking issue related to the downtown parking issue in terms of policy or you know, comprehensive anything?
When I think about this, I think about getting to the point that our bylaws for new buildings require certain numbers of parking spaces per units or something, or something like that, or that they, I'm not saying it's the way it would end up, but that parking is taken into consideration with the building of new housing.
Right. And
I'm not saying there's a magic formula.
Maybe zoning takes that up. I don't know.
So I feel like the zoning did take that on, and there are bylaws, but then there were a lot of special permits that were given. I don't know for sure, but I think that in certain circumstances. So maybe even just looking at, do we want to implement them, or so maybe zoning and planning too, along with us, like we should have, like, this is our vision, this is what we're thinking, and then
that's your master plan.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So again, I reiterate Evan's comment. I don't know what this means. I don't know what a comprehensive parking strategy means.
Well, and you all liked me.
I would take out the whole thing.
Just
say nothing about parking.
Just be silent as a major.
Yeah, parking
as a high
falls
level.
In somewhere else. You want a parking in
here? I'm still playing with it.
Me too.
Yeah.
Kind of bunching it around to you.
I mean, I keep thinking about the Gateway, the UTAC work on the Gateway stuff, and it talked about the necessity of shared parking in new development in the Gateway area. And shared parking meets some really important goals. So is shared parking part of our idea of a parking strategy?
Does anything feel better if I merge it into transportation?
No, they're
you
different.
Want it out of
the And I have to tell you, I'm also going back to our original, literally the translation of our original Butcher paper.
Right.
It was there, but it was only downtown.
Right. Well, except they're going to. Go ahead, Sarah.
Go ahead.
I was just going to say, I feel like there are issues growing in North Amherst.
It totally does.
Because of the development there.
So you know what I'm going to say about that? Because George is like, oh, I don't know. But I mean, like, so if you're reading a lot of articles about, you know, how there are people are building, like, resilient towns or strong towns, and, you know, what are, you know, components of those things, parking is something that is really considered.
It's supposed to be central.
Creating, you know, like the best town ever, the most resilient or strong town ever, like, and even to the point where people are really talking about what kind of structures. Do we do away with parking lots? Are we looking at putting, you know, bigger garages a little bit on the outskirts of town? Like, I think that that's something, parking is actually piece of planning.
That's true.
So, I think it just is we're not.
A park and ride and, you know.
And I'm thinking about North Amer, North Common presentation happened many, many months ago.
Yeah.
They talked about the park, not removing that park, the parking lot, not the Spring Street one, but the, but changing it so that it could be used for community gatherings and things like that. So there was a sense of using different materials in the lot instead of asphalt. So that to me, again, is like what you're saying, it's a strategy, it's an idea. If we had, you know, that, because then you're not trapped with a parking lot if we ever get to the place where we're less car dependent as a community.
We certainly want to have these conversations, I hear you, at the council level. And it's, so, you know, as we would talk about transportation, as we talk about housing.
You know, so would you, you know, bigger towns than ours, but not that much bigger, sometimes have, you know, slightly remote lots, could, like that Bank America or the high school lot,
right,
which on certain days there's a shuttle running you back and forth to town. You don't bring your car into
right.
town. That
right.
would be a part of a parking strategy that
right.
would only happen
so
on.
So could we have establishing and developing a flexible parking strategy or
a workable.
Yeah.
A workable, but there's,
that even,
that's,
as opposed
I'm not
to,
sure.
See, I put an unworkable and inflexible first.
Is this just your torture?
A comprehensive or a totally non.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That would get people's attention.
It's just
right.
Otherwise, this just says, yeah, you know, right, I'm from
so
Butter
if you
Apple
did, if you
but
put
it isn't
down,
just that.
If you put
know,
downtown
but,
and village centers, I think it solves some of your problems.
Yeah.
You know, it's
no,
where the density comes in that the, although there's on the street, what can you park on the street, not park, and all the neighborhoods.
I'm trying to like
it's,
think
it's
of
everywhere.
So
it's literally
so
everywhere.
So parking is literally in what we're doing with cars and not cars.
Right.
Like that is literally a growing, really big, very different. I've not felt good since this morning, so bear with me. Like that's actually something that is like in and of itself, like this big separate evolving ball that goes
mm-hmm.
with the new ideas of planning a town. So I feel like that should be like maybe there's a subcommittee, you know, maybe under, you know, like CRC there's a subcommittee, but then the new town government is something that's aware of and sort of like at some level oversees how we're looking at it and implementing our ideas.
So I think you're saying that the wording but I think your wording that you still would like review, develop, and adopt. I mean, it is like we're, you know, we're trying
right.
to.
Yeah, no,
we're, there's no reason not to approach this.
Should we say innovative? Should we say?
I think we expect it to be all of that.
Yeah.
So right now, I have review, develop, and adopt a comprehensive downtown
yeah.
and village center parking plan
mm-hmm.
/ priorities.
Yeah.
I could do with that.
Let's do it.
George doesn't want to be on
no.
this committee.
I'm just wondering if in
put
some
his name
sense,
down.
But you know what?
Is
instead of
a by other existing committees or existing bodies, but what I'm hearing is that this is something the council probably should and you all do want to have our minds focused on and our hands in. Not just
if, and if you change the word,
maybe the absolute without question one goal that all of us 2.5 years from now are saying. I know we didn't accomplish that
no,
one.
Yeah.
But we made this much progress
okay,
toward
so
it.
No, okay. So I guess
I'm
and
fascinated by curriculum, Georgia.
No, I'm not denying
and,
any of that.
And
I'm
Lynn,
just,
if rather than it be a parking
yeah.
plan,
so
I think if you said parking policies, because we're going to have, can you park here? How many cars do you have to have? Where do you park? It won't be like one plan. In the you know, it's going to be.
But a plan to me is it a
okay.
comprehensive
yeah.
plan has multiple
okay.
right.
addresses it in multiple ways.
Right, exactly. It's multifaceted.
When you start saying policies, I really
okay.
get scared. All
right, so we just
no
so
policy,
George
no
doesn't
policy.
Like the plan, the strategy,
so
and
we'll
he's and
minority,
he's and
we'll issue a minority document.
No, I'll tell you.
You're gonna have to sit in the back of the room for this.
So here's
I get to speak on it too, right?
You can be the audience and vocal quality for public comment.
So what's interesting about this is the emails you've been getting on what is our policy for where Uber can pick you up and leave you off.
Just bring that up with Evan.
He's wrong again.
No, you're not.
No, but then the thing we sat in an TAC where they warned that these motorized scooters, some towns now, they said, you should think of that people are going to be on motorized bikes that don't go very fast, little scooters that, you know, so yeah. All of that's on these streets we've got out here. Where do you park your scooter?
Yeah. Oh, my God.
And they talked about how many are likely to be in Amherst compared, you know,
yes.
Like Holyoke.
One of the things that happens also here is you, by your saying, no, got us all talking, and I feel like it helped us clarify.
No,
so I think that's really important.
It is.
My nervousness is creating like a plan that deals with parking.
Well,
it's just but I hear what you're saying, and you're right. So let's leave it, and I don't know how you want to word it, but you know, at this point.
Well, because I think what you're doing, George, you know, so it is, we'll figure. It's like we're not going to have one plan that works for the next 5 years. We're going to have to be constantly. We're going to have to be constantly. Scooters are coming. What do we do with scooters? Uber's parking in front of and getting tickets.
Right.
Suddenly,
and it's very long.
You know, so it becomes one of these things. Anticipating what the next thing is, trying to figure out.
Downtown and village centers included in this sense.
Because that takes away your.
Do you all want that?
I do. Because you're not going to start talking about the parking on Flat Hills Road.
No.
Or on Owen
except
Drive or places that.
Except when it's near your house.
Yeah. That's when we talk about potholes.
I mean, I'm with the TAC with the Lincoln, you know, the parking in Lincoln.
Yeah. But that's downtown, though.
Well, that was something the TAC was
all right,
trying to figure
I just
out.
Sent you this marked up version.
Okay.
I want us to at least get this adopted because we may have to meet again before we.
Oh, before council?
Before
next
council.
Week?
Yeah. Okay, so. All
right.
I've sent you version 4.
Okay. And you want us to look at it now?
I think that's all 8 minutes next time.
Okay.
This is really
funny.
But
we're gonna have to tell.
Feel so good about yours?
It should be in the you sent it
okay,
in the email.
So I'm not
like a kid.
That's all right. That's fine. There it is, version 4.
So we're going to have to tell IT at some point that we're not using SharePoint as they had hoped. Because
mm-hmm.
SharePoint's scary.
No, it doesn't work well.
It doesn't work. You know, I uploaded a document with track changes in it, and it accepted all the changes as if they weren't in it anymore. And
okay.
I thought, well, that's
so
useless.
So let's look and see
right?
whether or not we feel like
this
is
ready
is
for
it.
Prime time.
Yeah.
Draft town council goals is recommended by the town council. Goals ad hoc committee.
Yeah.
Ongoing.
You could, the very, as George says, it's a lot of words in the first, you could say town council goals has recommended by the goals ad hoc committee. You can get rid of the second town council and everyone will know who we are. But don't worry
also
about that.
Also, in their elementary school district, it's not the elementary school committee. It would just be
the
school
plain old
committee.
School committee.
Right. So let's go through each one.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
Yes.
Yeah, that's all right.
Okay,
so
I took out town council goals.
So it says town council goals is recommended by the goals ad hoc committee.
Yeah.
Right. First line is okay. It's okay. Second
mm-hmm.
entry.
Budget and fiscal.
Can you see?
Oh, I'm sorry.
I just don't want to lose this. Sometimes I do save
oh,
as.
Yeah.
And it's
no,
like
no,
if I've
no,
taken
no.
these down and I said
yeah.
I would take minutes, then I would
is
look like
control
a
plus?
Fool.
Is that, this will probably delete it. Is this what
it should make it bigger.
So
yeah.
Elementary school district.
It
says partner with the elementary school committee.
I think it should just say school committee.
With school committee. That's
because
right.
there's no elementary school committee.
Partner
yeah.
with
minor
the school partner. Committee to secure a new elementary school's regional school district adopt assessment plans and budgets.
Now, there still is this tension. I mean, if I were on the council seeing this for the first time, I would scratch my head and say, and maybe we'll just have to explain it, but all these seem like ongoing, year in and year out things, except for elementary school district, which doesn't. Because everybody knows that once this is done, one way or the other, it's
well,
done.
Well, we did say it's going to be minimally a 3-year process.
But why not just throw it down year one and beyond?
Yeah, George, I think you're right. I think you're right. The other things are...
I mean, we could just say we just finally, you know, decided it was the best we could do, but it's going to be an objection. Someone's going
to
raise.
Do you want me to move all the education ones?
No. Just if you made the elementary school, if it said, instead of it said elementary school district, it said elementary school, okay, or schools, and then partner with, and it made it the very first thing in 1 year and beyond, it makes, that's our biggie. Like we want to get.
Oh, right, and it's still in line with the other two.
Right.
Because then we have regional.
So I say elementary schools.
Yeah, and then it's partner with the elementary school committee
to secure.
So that becomes just before master plan, and it's like something we're doing now and. Yeah.
Just get rid of elementary
school district because
so
it's not.
I'm taking this out.
Right.
So elementary schools.
Yeah.
Dash. Partner with the elementary school.
No, with the school committee.
With the
school committee.
School committee to secure a new elementary school for Amherst.
Right, and that becomes
and
such
that
a cool first one under year one and beyond, right?
Right, I agree.
So I'm cutting
it's
it
actually
there,
concrete.
I'm putting
what?
It
concrete.
Year one.
Literally,
that's
right.
All right. Then I'm leaving regional school district where it is.
Right?
Yep.
And I'm leaving higher ed where it is.
Yes.
Now, imagine if, I won't name any names here, but a counselor might ask, well, you've got regional schools and you've got higher ed. Where's the elementary school?
Right.
We point down below. Okay, good. That's our answer.
And also, and George, the other thing is under budget and fiscal, that's what Lynn was saying, is it's enfolded in our annual budget the same way library is,
right.
So
right.
It
so
comes,
have
right. So it's not
that's
a,
right.
We're
good.
Not voting
good.
On it separately.
Yeah. Year one, capital plan slash project, adopt a comprehensive capital plan.
You want those all capital, comprehensive capital plan,
yeah.
CC and P?
Rules of procedure, develop and adopt rules of procedure for the town council. Bylaw review, complete and adopt the general and zoning bylaws. See zoning bylaw goal. Public ways, develop and adopt a plan for approving public way requests.
Can I ask why you're saying that?
Yes.
I'm going to take that out.
Okay.
She's going to type, sorry.
The parentheses, see zoning,
zoning yeah,
bylaw goal.
Yeah.
Just take it out.
Everybody okay with the up those four?
Mm-hmm.
Year one and beyond.
Now it's elementary school is the first one.
Good. Good.
Master plan is the second.
Review, like, adopt the master plan. So
mm-hmm.
Review, assess, and revise.
Okay, I have one comment on zoning,
yeah.
And last time when I raised it, everyone didn't think it made sense, but I'll just raise it again.
Okay.
I think some of the zoning things that we'll be considering are going to be proposed by people who have visionary development ideas. And they may or may not be related directly to the master plan. You know, I mean, it's not that they're unrelated, but it's not because someone said, oh, the master plan said this, and that's why we've got to do that. So
mm-hmm.
I'm just, so it says to bring in conformity with the master plan. It's like restricting ourselves. So, you know, in other words, you know, so,
mm-hmm.
so,
mm-hmm.
Steve made a, you know, he
how
said
about consistent with the master plan?
Consistent with the master plan or our vision of what the Amherst we want. You know, it's,
well,
you
so
know.
That's the master
plan.
That,
that
is
the
master plan.
That is the,
plan.
I know,
the
I, that's why.
But
and then
I,
we're
I,
going over the master plan,
yeah,
so maybe
right.
we want to.
So we may, but I think getting rid of conformity is would be,
okay.
That would work.
And use what, consistent?
Consistent makes
yeah.
sense.
Review, assess, and revise zoning bylaws consistent
with the
master
plan.
Okay. Does that meet your
well, it does.
Yeah,
you know, I'm.
Yeah.
I wish I had sat in when Northampton was changing theirs, and whether they were constantly referencing their master plan, or they were saying, we want to do these kinds of development, and here's some reasons why. It brings in affordable housing, it does this, or did they always reference the master plan, or were they saying, we don't have any place for a retiree to live in a condo downtown, and is a condo downtown ever mentioned in the master, you know, so it's anchoring it only in the, I don't mind anchoring it in the master plan, so I wouldn't want to do it.
But you're afraid it might suggest
what
that
about
if it didn't, if it didn't say,
in conformity with or consistent with master plan goals.
That would be work.
Because goals is, again, the it's a larger.
Does the master plan have goals?
Yes,
yeah.
Yes. That works, Pat. That changes my hope because they have high-level goals.
Right.
Okay.
And that gives the flexibility that you're talking about.
Yes,
and
that's very, so then you can say consistent with master plan goals, right? That fixes my concern.
Everybody thinks something different when they see the master plan.
Right.
And see, that's and it helps me because at the goal level, you can imagine where other things that went underneath that goal,
right,
but you didn't have to mention those things.
That's
you
right.
Should, yeah,
right.
That solves my problem completely.
So review, assess, and revise zoning bylaws.
Where are we? I'm sorry.
We're
consistent with.
Consistent with.
Master plan
goals. I don't think you need to do that, Sarah, but
I'm going to sort it out later.
That's okay, because ultimately it's what Lynn puts in her document.
So, yeah, and I think that everything that I'm just going to have it in
okay.
In case,
yeah.
But I'm just pretty much going to say that we discussed goals. We discussed activities, and please see the
revised
documents.
Which was revised by consensus.
Yeah.
I was just taking some of the stuff down,
for
me, and also,
good.
In case anything seems so tantalizing that we discussed.
Okay.
So far, no.
So, housing, review, develop, and adopt a comprehensive
housing
plan / priorities.
So when you do / priorities, is that just to make your sentence shorter? Because if it said and priorities, it's two things. You've got a plan, and then you're also setting.
And what are the priorities of that plan?
You know, so if I think all I'm saying is instead of the / put the word and, so
that's
plan
fine.
And priorities.
Do you want to say and set priorities?
It said adopt priorities, so I'm looking
verb.
Back at the original verb.
Yeah,
George, I think adopt priorities, I think still works, right?
That's fine. Adopt plan and priorities.
And that would be true for transportation.
Same.
And parking.
Yes.
That makes it easier to say you've got a plan and priorities, so the plan might be the 40-year plan, but what we're working on. Not in my lifetime, but
you know.
Oh,
well.
So let me ask you this. Do you want me to now just accept all changes and send you the next clean copy?
Yeah, I've been doing mine.
This is version 5.
Well, Lynn, I've been typing as we did in the, you know, the accept, and it looks really nice. So if you did that, they're going to like it. I think it looks really nice.
looks are important.
Looks are important. Only a couple of these things are more than one line long, which I like.
Or 4B.
No.
See, it's been a month or two of doing version 27.
Oh, God.
My laptop just changed the font.
27?
Well, we're on.
Oh, that happens. Isn't that annoying when that happens?
Yeah, just
now. From version 6. So it's interesting.
We're supposed to be in your time zone.
Yes.
I have one more edit as you're accepting.
Oh, I already did.
Okay, but on elementary school,
if
you remove the word forever, since clearly
yeah,
it's understood,
it
in elementary school
you.
One becomes one line. I mean, you can look at it later.
Sure
yeah, I'm going to send this to you.
Yeah.
All right. Now you have.
Excuse me.
All right.
Various places where I have little edits. So I've now sent you version 5.
But we weren't done yet.
This is everything that we just did and then you can keep going.
I think, we were just down to energy and sustainability, I believe.
Ah.
You're right, but we already
massaged
them.
All right, so you want us to look at version 5 now.
Right.
Yes, there she goes.
Okay, so a couple little
Sarah, you wanna see
and it? Priorities, you need spaces. So my suggestion now that I see elementary schools, do we need 4 Amherst at the end? Because number one,
all for Amherst.
It's all for Amherst.
Okay,
and then, see,
six.
That's my delight in one-line goals. I get the elementary school down to one line.
Yeah, it won't bother me.
And Mandy Jo will find something.
No,
bless her heart.
That's all right.
It is all right. It is all right.
Well, we'll make her make a change.
So she might suggest on ad hoc if the A is capitalized, the H is also, but I have no idea what, you know, and that's where.
Are we using Oxford Commons?
I have.
Yes,
yeah.
We are.
We are.
What did you just say? Oxford
Commons?
Oxford
Commons.
What is an Oxford comma?
Ask me.
Go ahead.
No, I want you to know.
No?
Yes.
What is an Oxford
What
comma?
Is an
so
Oxford?
So you say, if you're making a list of something, so you say groceries, cars, and horses. You do groceries, you do a comma, right? You do cars, you do a comma, and then, and I forget horses. So everything you don't.
Everything gets separated.
See, I would write groceries, comma, cars, and horses.
Oh, I've always done Oxford commas.
I
don't.
You
can
do
both.
I just
English
didn't
major,
even.
You can do both, but it's more correct. I feel it feels more comfortable than even doing Oxford commas.
Right. Just because that's what. That's
so what's interesting? So that's the way I've always
right.
done
and these
it.
These are usually people who also want a comprehensive parking.
So.
And you're the guy who had. Never mind.
This
I'm
is
not
what
make that
I
joke.
Would like to do. Is I would like to save this.
See, Lynn has an Oxford comma in her sentence.
I always have Oxford.
I do too.
Okay.
Always.
Well, Mandy, will like,
it,
Mandy
yeah.
will like that.
We will all like that.
We'll
like except
it.
You.
It's consistent
that's
capitalization.
Right.
I get that.
Okay, anything else here you want changed?
Okay.
No, you already found the spacing on one of the end priorities. You fixed that?
Right.
It was just a wrong. I just fixed it in the one I got.
Here, move it.
You'll see it.
Move back. I can still see it.
So we'll just found another one.
Oh, we didn't get rid
down
of comprehensive. We're leaving.
We're leaving comprehensive in for everything.
I was just thinking that, and it should be village center.
Centers.
Yeah.
Right.
Review,
thank
develop,
you.
And adopt a comprehensive downtown and village centers,
and
parking plan, and priorities.
I don't think you need the capital P in
the
center.
Take that out,
okay.
Right? How about under energy? Is it, should
adopt
I leave those all caps?
You would say, like, does it belong to anything? So that would belong to Amherst. So you could keep it capitalized.
Yeah.
Where were you when I was trying to write all those term papers?
Sarah, want to come over?
You
popcorn and soda?
Yeah.
Oh, and I have this paper.
Okay, so take it from the top. I'm not. If we can find another meeting time, I'm not going to ask us to adopt this today.
That's fine.
Yeah.
You don't think these are good?
Oh, I think they are, but what I want to do then is talk about what do I need to do to get the other sheet
ready,
and then we'll meet and do the whole thing.
So putting the two of them together.
Yeah.
And so you can go back and forth and not suffer some kind of
right.
Can people do the next
cognitive
Friday,
distance.
Or is that still too late?
Sorry? Friday next
I'd
week?
I'd like not to do Friday only because we have so much problem getting stuff.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Oh, let me, I have to grab my calendar.
Okay, so Word thinks you have no spelling and no grammar problems.
Excellent.
Are you happy?
Oh, next meeting. I'm 8 minutes. Let's put that
and
in.
And adjust the goals.
So the earliest we can meet is Wednesday. And that's because of posting.
And Wednesday's horrible.
Next
morning.
Week, you will not have me physically.
next week at all.
No, I'm in New York.
What are we talking about?
Well, we're trying to schedule one more meeting to put these two pieces together and look at them synoptically.
Right now, time on Tuesday after 3:30.
Can't get it posted.
And Lynn says she has to, it would have had to be posted.
When do you need this?
I can't post till Monday. So it's got to be at the latest, at the earliest it can be is Wednesday morning.
Oh, I see. Wednesday the 17th in the morning. I have bylaw review till 10:30.
Okay.
And I can't miss it because I just missed one.
If you could do back, if you could bear back to back, I could do 10:30.
My problem is I have a interview I'm doing at 11:30.
Lynn, the 16th doesn't work?
We can't get it posted fast enough.
Oh, on that part, that's the posting.
So now let's go to the 17th.
Thursday, morning, the moment's fun.
We have JCPC. Do we have JCPC next week?
No.
Oh, Thursday morning?
Yeah, I'm clear Thursday morning.
Yeah, there is a trial of someone that I know, but I don't know if I'm going to go, so it doesn't matter. Thursday, what time?
What time?
I don't know if that's Max's post-op appointment, but let's set a time and then we'll figure it out because maybe Joe can.
Is he back?
Maxie?
Yeah.
Oh, Joe? No, he's not back yet. He had a flight from Hong Kong to San Francisco, and then we'll see how he gets home from San Francisco.
Oh,
but at least he's not still stuck in Hong Kong or India, so that's cool.
All right, 9:30, what do you want?
We're talking about Thursday?
Thursday, yes.
I'm flexible.
I would say 9:30 only because 9, I think, is hard.
9:30 to 11:30?
No, 9:30 is good, yep.
So if you are short a quorum, I can, I'm totally available.
Make sure you file a form to ask.
Yes, but so we,
but if you don't need to, then
I would only impose that on you if you need a fourth.
So we're doing.
And what time again? 9:30.
9:30.
My week looks open next week. That's scary.
And anything you get to me, Lynn, I will. If I'm not calling, I'll just send you.
Great.
And copy of it. Well, I can't copy everyone. I can just send you.
Right. So what I want to do now, though, is I want to go back and say, what do you think the worksheet should look like? Mm. I mean, besides having a, for instance, it would have the goals. That one's clear. Should it have a separate column that says referred to?
I would say yes.
Yeah. Okay. So, and then that way suggested activities.
Can you do, I'm just looking at, what I'm wondering is if the goal was here and then this thing that has all the writing here says referred to here. And then it has activities, and then dot, dot, dot. Then you make a distinction between referred to and then activities include?
That's what I tried to do.
And just up here, you've got the referred to up here, so I'm thinking this all goes, this red that's there now that was space, right now it's done in draft form where everything was penciled in here, so if that, I'm imagining if that wasn't there, and it said referred to right here, and then it's, it said activities include or, and then there's the list.
But the activities include would be,
so I'm trying to, I liked the old column that said activities include. Now you've got referred, but you could still keep that without making another.
Well, referred to doesn't have to be a very large column. Why can't it be its own column?
So just its own little tiny skinny thing where there's nothing.
Because
the only thing is you're going to have
initials,
a goal here with nothing underneath it, referred to, which has nothing underneath it, and then a big long sentence. It's just you're going to get something.
A disproportionate.
Yeah.
You're going to get something that's wider and wider where two of the columns are blank underneath. It's just, it's my space conserving on a sheet, visual.
Yeah.
So that's it.
Okay, let me try another idea on you. Under the goal.
That's the other place you could put
the referred to.
That as a second line, that would work.
Oh.
That would work.
Underneath, but in the same column.
Yeah.
Underneath.
Then if it's over there, then that, and then this column could be had, then this column could be headed the way you had it headed before, would had activities, or whatever you called it, you know.
Suggested activities.
Suggested activities. Then that would, then that solves my problem, that there's something underneath a column, yep.
Okay, and then the rest, then do you, then what I think we are gonna have to grapple with is, and I think this first one is the hardest, by the way, is what do we actually include under the suggested activities?
Under the,
The town manager evaluation to be an activity.
Right.
And the establishment of the economic development committee as a suggested activity.
We definitely want.
What does, do you have things in there like ranked choice voting? That's, that would be part of the new government, but I don't know if that's important in the sense.
That's a decision whether to do it or not, right? I mean, we have a group out there figuring out.
Right.
Well,
here are ways.
Well,
so it's not an input, it's go out and come back and tell us the ways we could do it and bring it back, and then we make a decision as the town as we want to. So that's not part of the new government yet, it's some.
So our, so just to take an example here, establish standing committees is my first activity.
Yeah.
And I'm not even gonna say of the town council, I'm just gonna say whatever. And then under that, I can even name
The
standing committees.
Yes.
Yes.
Well, yes and no, but see, what I like is, I'm reading down what you have now, is the goal is to have committees established with clear jurisdiction and guidelines.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's a goal, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, so we don't have to say exactly which, you know, we've set ourselves up, so I wouldn't make it more complicated than that. I like that wording
that's
a lot.
Sense.
What?
So
the goal is that we have established committees that know what they're doing.
So,
you know,
but
right?
so in other words, you don't want the activity to be established standing committees.
Right.
You want it to be established standing committees with clear jurisdiction and guidelines.
Right.
Yes.
Did I see under your the rows? I'm reading just down. I'm not even adding words. Down. To me, you know, it's already there in three rows down. I like that a lot. You know.
Yeah.
Right. So I was reading. It wasn't coming up with a sentence. I was reading.
All right.
And when you make it broad, like you don't even have to use the word standing committees, though you can. We've got ad hoc committees.
Right,
we've got committees.
Right. Whatever we want them to have clear jurisdiction and guidelines.
Establish.
We'll establish appointments process.
Establish committees. I, you know what, I'd like to say standing ad hoc.
Okay.
And because they're councils.
Yeah.
They're council committees.
And I think this with clear jurisdiction and guidelines, that's.
Yep. Okay.
We're still working through that. So
yeah.
Hopefully
that's
in a year we.
We'll have received it. Yeah.
All right. Then.
What is the point of establishing and accomplish the goal outlined above? Outlines.
It means accomplish the goals that are here.
But do we need that? As
I don't
well?
Think.
If
that.
You put anything there, I would put set goals for the council. I mean, we
there
want
you go.
That,
yeah.
Right? It's not that we're, we want to set ourselves up with goals. You know, so
yeah.
If you want anything about goals, I would put set goals.
Or establish goals.
Or establish goals. What it, but
right,
it's
just to keep the.
But why don't we want to say that we want to accomplish them?
Because.
That will.
We don't.
Okay.
That's the dirty
but wouldn't the accomplishment be as part of it? We're not saying establish the foundation, accomplish a strong foundation of the town. I don't know. I don't think you need it.
That first
adopt goals. Adopt goals.
Yeah.
So exactly, because
establish
this is
and utilize goals.
It just seems so.
It seems more. At least that's, I'm not sure that's what you. you would want to put, but accomplishing the goals, goals are,
it's just.
What do we want to say?
I'm wondering if you need to say anything.
We don't even have, so I think George is right, we don't have to set that here, but we're setting up a new kind of government is the goal.
Yeah.
So we're putting in place committees that know what they're doing. We're putting an appointment process in place. We're figuring out how to evaluate. And then at the very end, we can.
Progress towards transparency.
And we could have, the very last thing, but set goals to hold us accountable. You could say that, or we could be silent, because all these other things.
Every 2 years.
In our case, after 3 years, but every 2 years, assuming.
You have to actually do them every year, because it.
No, this, yes, but I'm thinking about being held accountable.
So I like stripping it out for a couple reasons. If we say this is what we want to do, and we've got these other things in, you could judge whether we've set up a new town government at the end of the year by whether we have any of these things in place.
Right.
Then you could come later and say, have we, in fact, done anything about housing? Have we, in fact, done anything about each of these things, right?
So in essence, we're looking at ourselves the same way we want to have.
Right.
As a goal protection, right?
Right.
So we don't have to have on the goals to have goals.
Right, you got it.
Got it, all right, you got it. Moving on.
It was a quick check, right?
Town manager evaluation, establish process to evaluate town manager. Evaluate town manager, you have to, you just have to do it.
Right.
But is that the next thing in line?
In terms of order of things?
Yeah.
You might want to put public engagement communication. You might put the town manager evaluation way down.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
It's obviously something we need to do, it's obviously important, but I think from the point of view of.
And when you're looking at it, Lynn, when you go and edit it again, we're more detailed on this than we need to. So you can just figure out what you want, you know, like.
Yes.
First we figure out what his goals are, then we figure out an evaluation process, then we implement the evaluation places, then we do the evaluation process, then we review it.
We definitely don't want this
at
the top.
All right, so
the other thing is that we're now calling these suggested activities because we want either the town council, the whole, what is it called? The committee of the whole, or individual committees.
But whatever, but it has more steps in this thing than the master plan does.
I'm under, so the next one, for instance, is just to develop and adopt processes to encourage broad resident participation.
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. Appointments.
So where, do you still have appointments as high level? I thought we'd moved appointments underneath setting up the town government.
It is.
Oh, okay. Oh, you're still reading down that?
I'm still doing activities under this one.
Okay, so I had jumped.
We're lost.
Yeah, I was lost.
Under establishing town government, we had talked about.
Moving the public engagement to a line up there?
To one of the activities.
And I think.
Oh, right, that's right.
So under, right now, under this, I have.
You have robust public, the one I'm reading says robust public participation with input, influence meetings, public forum, and increased attendance. So it,
is that a whole goal?
Well, no, it's all under this, at least the sheet I'm looking at.
Yeah, maybe we're looking at different documents.
Right? Are we looking at this?
You're absolutely right. What I'm not doing is looking at what I've already written.
We're looking at draft 4.
Yeah, I'm looking at the draft you sent to us, I think.
Robust public participation.
Am I?
Implement district meetings, public forum, Cheryl.
We have all the.
Hopefully you're looking at an older one, not a newer one.
I am. Don't worry.
That's all right.
Establish appointment process, establish and accomplish goals outlined above.
So you had done this last time nicely, I thought. You know, I mean, it may need some.
Yeah, but it's in good shape.
And the progress towards transparency, I don't think we need taping of all meetings, minutes approved. I don't think we need that.
Some of me thinks that making kind of a comprehensive list is gonna help us like check things off. I would assume that at the end of our tenure, people are gonna say, well, what did you do?
And we'll have this.
And we'll have this.
And they'll be all blank.
Right.
They proved.
You may never have, you may never have seen them, but we taped every time.
Yeah, you may never have seen them.
Okay, I've lost, we're now on the main goal of establishing the new government.
Right.
So I put down establish standing and ad hoc committees as, in parentheses, as needed, with clear jurisdiction and guidelines. Develop and adopt processes that encourage broad resident participation.
Okay, so you're editing the sentences I'm looking at, yes?
Yes, or I'm moving them is what I'm doing. Okay, so then my next question is, what goes next?
In this list. Well, part of the problem, I'm afraid, is that you, the changes you're making, we're not seeing, and.
Yeah, it's hard.
And we like a lot of what we're looking at, so.
Yeah, we like, you know, so I like to establish an appointment process.
Part of the problem, you're looking at what we're looking at.
Maybe what we've done is, this is the beginning of five.
So I, would, my advice would be, at 10 of six.
Right, I understand.
Yeah, I got it.
I liked almost everything I saw in four, and then we still had a lot of choices, so whatever new you put in, do a clean version for us to see next time with all the track changes removed.
Right.
And to the extent, George's comment, Kathy's comment, Mandy's comment, anyone else's comment has been addressed, remove the comment, you know, like taken care of, it's gone. And leave anything that still.
That sounds good to me.
So in other words, I'm gonna try to bring to you as clean a copy of this worksheet. That would be the worksheet we would share along with adopting the goals.
Yeah. And what you'll end up wanting to do, Lynn, is because we wordsmithed a little bit the actual, just the goals.
Yeah.
So that wording has to be the exact same wording here, so people can go from one pager.
Can we help, or can we help, Lynn, in the sense that if she gives us, we have the just the goal, she will send us the clean copy that, right?
You could send the individuals.
In the intervening time, how can we get comments to her that would be useful?
Individuals.
Right.
As a list or something.
Well, the main thing I can, the only thing I can think of doing that would not be confusing would be to accept every edit in here, and then add any other ones I have. You know, in other words, or I don't understand there, so I would move it. So I would send her the same clean copy she's creating for herself.
I will try, what I
need
to do.
But right now, we have so many track changes, you couldn't see my new track change.
I will send you as clean of a new copy as I can.
And we'll work through that.
And we've already just addressed, you know, how do you want me to take care of the issue of referred to?
Sure, right.
Already addressed that.
And activities, right.
And suggested activities.
Right.
Right, so we got that.
Moving some things around, if you want.
I think that'll work well, and then as soon as you can, whenever we get that, particularly if I'm not participating by phone because you don't need it for a quorum, I will do my changes in track edit and just send it back to you.
You'll be here in spirit.
I'll be here in spirit.
And if we don't understand, we'll just call you up.
Well, having worked,
we can't do that.
Having worked in group writing where we never talked to each other and just did that, I could be here in spirit.
It's the only thing I did that tons of times, but not with open meeting law.
I know, well, I can't talk. And only one of you can see what I send,
right.
So that's the whole new ball of wax.
Right.
Like Jim, Lynn, I guess during the time you're all together, Lynn can share it.
Yeah,
yes.
No, I can.
Yeah.
Then we can deliberate together.
That's right.
That's what we're supposed to
do. But it's like you can't pre-see what someone thought.
This will not be our last meeting, so I won't
get
send
15
any song
emails since I last spoke.
So if the four of you have all confirmed, 9:30 works for you, quorum is not a problem, so I just will not even bother to pre-file paperwork.
Right. And
Michelle
and
I will
be here.
You know, Michelle and I can come, then you'll be more than four.
Yeah.
Yeah. More than four, more than
four. Four, more than a quorum.
All right.
So are we?
Excellent.
Are
Okay, I move to adjourn.
A second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Let the record show we adjourned at 5:50.